So, in this video I want to show upgrade in macro functions M3 and M4. So, when I open this file, open Mach3 macros M3. So so I had this until today, and so how it works. So when you buy Mach3, you usually in M3 function, I will try to zoom. So when you buy Mach3, usually in M3 macro or function, you have only do spin CW or spindle clockwise, and rest of code I added. And why I add rest of code, because machining process need to start when programmed RPM is reached. So for example, if I want spindle to run at 3000 RPM, tools are allowed to move only when spindle is at 3000 RPM. So inside is some logic, and I will try to explain. So get OM DRO 39 means if real spindle speed is greater than zero, or in other words, does spindle rotates already. So if it rotates, then RPM is greater than zero. So I wrote here what every code does it means. So 39 is true spindle RPM, and 870 is spindle speed or programmed spindle speed. So this is a logic, and so if real spindle speed is greater than zero, then that means that spindle already rotates, and I didn't know how to program otherwise, so I put some constant time which I determined by experimenting. So I put wait 1.3 seconds, or in Visual Basic language you need to write like this: sleep 1300, and after that time there is another check. So while real RPM is smaller than program RPM, wait 5 milliseconds. So it loops inside until this condition is true. And usually happens that I program, for example, 3000 RPM, and in reality my VFD generates such frequency that I get 3005 RPM. So this is why I made conditions like that. I will show a little bit later. And so we have if then, obligatory is to wait 1.3 seconds, and after that do this check, or it is another case. So 2 RPM was not greater than 0, that means that it's less than 0, so it means that spindle was in stop mode. So while true RPM is smaller than program RPM, you be inside of this loop and wait for 5 milliseconds, so until real RPM doesn't overshoot program RPM, we are inside of this loop, and that works okay. This case works perfect. Thing is with this constant, because sometimes I machine something, for example with 4000 RPM and M3 or spindle clockwise is activated, and I want to still use M3, but I want to machine with, I don't know, 1000 RPM. And because I have DC braking, spindle can decelerate or stop or decrease RPM pretty fast. So this constant is not necessary in that case, but it will be executed, and this thing I didn't like. But when this constant is necessary, for example when I want to machine something, so I'm machining something with 3000 RPM for example, and M3 is active, and I want to machine something with 2000 RPM, but I need M4 directional spindle, and to reach from, I don't know, 3000 to 2000 or what I said, I need, I don't know, half of seconds. But thing is that spindle need to change direction of rotation, and because encoder only shows in Mach 3 positive RPM, so there is no sign RPM is negative or RPM is positive, I'm taking in account with this constant cases that I have possible change of direction of spindle. So if I do not have this, and I have, for example, case if get OM draw is, or if true spindle is greater than 0, and for example I'm machining with 4000 RPM and M3 is active, and in my G code I need to execute code M4, but with 2000 RPM, if I do not have this, if I do not have this slip 1300, tool will very fast try to machine part. And thing is that spindle was in process of reversing direction, so this is why I need this. And yesterday I was trying to figure out how to solve this problem. Is it possible to make some logic? And again I came to conclusion that I need some memory. So when I activate M3, I need to save that data somewhere, so when I come in this line and I have check For example, real spindle is greater than zero, or spindle is rotating, I need to wait 1.3 seconds only if I want to change direction of spindle. If I do not want change direction of rotation, I do not need to wait 1.3 seconds, so I can wait only 5 milliseconds or half of seconds. It's not important, that is the idea only. And like I said, I couldn't find solution, but something crossed my mind, because I had this problem. I had problem, for example, this is a little bit so for example when I press, I'll do something like this. So when I press this button, try like this, so I want to show this button and this area. So when I press spindle, I can turn on or turn off spindle. Depends if spindle is active, when I press it, I will turn it off. If it's not active, when I press it, I will activate it. And thing is, then when you running your G code, and when you, for example, auto cycle, when you press feed hold or stop, and if in this area where is G code shown, if you start to machine something with M3, so M3 direction, the M3 direction of rotation, and when you press spindle, nothing will happen. But if you in code have M4 command and you stop spindle and you want to continue with execution of your program, when you press spindle will rotate with M3 directions and you have in program M4 direction. So I find out that this button doesn't take care which was previous active direction of rotation. And I went to, so I went to ask for help on Mach3 forum, and this is the name of topic: spindle button and M3 and M4. And here I got some suggestions to try, what to try. And for some reason I still didn't try that, but I was preparing to try. And I was looking what was written as what to do so I found solution for my previous problem with spindle at speed problem. So like I told in this long speech, I concluded that I can solve my spindle speed problem only if I use saving current state of rotation in file, and I thought it must be some simple way, and I found simple way. So this guy that was trying to help me offer solution for this problem, spindle button and M3 and M4, and I took part of that solution to solve this problem. I talked too much and not so nice, so I took solution from other problem to solve this problem. So I want this constant to be activated, so 1.3 seconds, I want this constant to be activated only in case when I have change of direction of spindle. If I'm machining something with 4000 RPM and M3 is active and I want to change RPM, so M3 is still active and RPM want to change from 3000 to 2000, I do not need to wait 1.3 seconds. It's enough to wait 5 milliseconds because VFD will stop, will decelerate very fast. So I don't know, is it possible to understand what I'm talking about? So I will try to show in video what is going on. So this is from where I took part of code, so I can try to see will I manage to solve spindle at speed, and I think that now it will work very good. I already tried and I do not know is it possible to make it better, but for me it works really really good now. So another thing that I need to show, I don't know, probably somebody can have VFD configured like that when he programs. So currently true RPM is zero and program is 4000, and for example when I give command spindle, so I want to have 4000 RPM. And thing is that in reality I always overshoot program RPM for every command that I give, I will overshoot program RPM. So for S 200 so in this case this is not good example. Yes. Apparently I found some bug, some execution, some exception of a rule. Anyway, I want to show that if I have program RPM to be 300, is it possible to see at some point it will overshoot? It's not important for how much, it will overshoot. So So let's see. S500 spindle. So again, it overshoots, and usually I machine everything with 1000 or more, 1000, 2000, 3000. Yes, 3000. So again, it will overshoot. So, and because of that, this is why my function looks like. So if true RPM is greater than zero, that means spindle is rotating and you need to wait 1.3 seconds. After that you need to wait until you need to be in this loop until the real RPM is less than program RPM. And as I showed before few seconds, in my case real RPM is always in 99%, and almost in 100% of cases it is always greater. So I will escape from this loop. So this is why I used this kind of logic. If real RPM is less than, this is my condition. If somebody have different act of his VFD, he needs to change this to suit his behavior of VFD. And so this is M3 file open. Now M4, this is how looks M4. And now now I want to show how that looks in reality. So when I machine something, file close. Now I want to show how this looks in reality. And first I need piece of paper. So piece of paper. Okay. So we are coming to machine. And so I will machine air, but I will show difference. I will move this little bit here in case of coolant squirts. So let's see. Spindle. Okay. So now I will run my code, which I was testing with outflow. Stop load. So cycle starts. So we are waiting for 4000 RPM and 4000 RPM is reached. This is not good, so I waited 1 second in this position because of 1.3 second constant, and now I need to wait because I have change of direction. Now again 1.3 seconds. It's not necessary to wait because I have M4. Now I need to wait because I changed direction. Okay, this is good. This also was not good because I program RPM change from 3000 RPM to 2500, and I unnecessarily waited for 1.3 seconds. And this is also good. And here I waited, so to show even more vivid, I will change that constant from 1300 to be, for example, 10,000, or to be 10 seconds. So it is possible to see better. Possible to see better what is the problem. So it's better to show here. So I will change this constant in M3 to be 10,000, or in other words 10 seconds. File save, file open. So I need to change that also in M4 because I have M3 and M4 direction of RPM. So file save, file save. I can close this and I can show what will happen. So cycle start. So I need to wait for 4000 RPM to start. to machine. That is okay. Okay. So now I wait 10 seconds totally unnecessary because I have dropped from 3000 to 2500. And now I need to wait because I'm changing direction of rotation. So this is okay, this is time again unnecessary to wait. Now I need to wait, but I wait too much, so 10 seconds it's not necessary, but I chose 10 seconds only to show exact moments when I have problems, apparently problems. Now again I'm waiting 10 seconds because I program drop from 3000 to 2500. And now again I have dropped from 2500 to 1500, and again unnecessary waiting too much. And again I'm waiting 10 seconds. I'm waiting 10 seconds. So, what I wanted to tell, oops, so, what I wanted to tell, so I need to open function M3. Operator file open. Okay, so like I said at beginning of video, when you buy Mach 3 or you have demo version or I don't know how it's called, you have only do spin clockwise and rest of the logic you can add by yourself or you can leave and play Russian roulette when you machine. So I decided to add something the best that I could find or was able to make, and this is what I had. So I had I was using or testing at home machine like this with sleep 1000, so 1000, or that means sleep 1 second, wait 1 second. File, save file, open file, M4. So instead of 10,000, I had this situation. File, save, and after I asked for help for this problem, spindle button, blah blah blah, I got idea what I can use to solve my problem. So I saved solution which I tested, so I will try to show. So here I saved code. So this is solution that will work much better. Copy file, open file, M3. So I will replace this, what I was talking 37 minutes about, with this. Okay, file, save, close, and again I need to make change in M4. Copy Mach3 operator file, open file, and I will replace this old code with new, which works better. File, save, file, open file, M3, and I will try to explain what I did. So this is the most important thing that I didn't know it's possible. So there exists some type of variables, and I took exact same case that I got on Mach3 forum. So I'm setting, so currently I'm in M3 function, and I'm setting, let's pretend that name of this variable is 1601, and by doing this I can enter or change its value to be 0. So I will mark with 0 this variable if I'm using M3, and because I'm in M3 function, I'm setting that variable to be 0. So because I made decision that when I'm in M3 function, I will set this variable to be 0. And why? Because I will, when I enter again in this function or this macro, I will check what was previous state of spindle. If it was 0, that means that previous command for controlling spindle was M3, and if it was 1, that means that previous command was M4. So I will show what is in M4. So when I'm in M4, I made decision to mark this variable with value 1. So when I'm in this function, after everything I doing in it, I will mark its value with 1. So I will mark some variable, it's not important, at least for me, vice 1601. I took it, tested it, and it works, so I'm just explaining what I'm doing. So I decide to put value 1, and let's go back in M3 function. No, oops, close file M3. So let's try to explain. So when I am in M3, that is clockwise direction, so do spindle clockwise, I'm testing. So in order to spindle start to rotate with M3 direction or clockwise direction, it will start after I come from this line to this line, and in order to come from this line to this line, something in between need to be executed, and that something in between, it can take different amount of time. So it can take, I don't know, 5 milliseconds, or it can take 1.3 seconds. So I will start with explaining. So if get OMDRO 39, that means if true RPM, what I can read from encoder, is greater than 0, that means that my spindle is already rotating, and possible scenario is I have, for example, 4000 RPM and I want to keep same direction, but I only want to drop RPM, or I want to raise it. So in that case, I need to check if previous state of spindle was M4. So if, like I said before, 1 minute, if get var is equal to 1, that means that I had M4 as active state of spindle before M3. And in that case, that means that I'm trying to reverse rotation of spindle, and because of that I need to wait 1.3 seconds. And why I need to wait 1.3 seconds? Because I made a lot of tests and I concluded that this is the optimal and the safest time for me. I can, for example, write here sleep 10,000 and I will wait 10 seconds and it will be totally unnecessary but totally safe. And I showed before in video how it looks when I wait 10 seconds. So by testing, running some test G-code, you can determine how much you need for this time to be. So if that is the case, then wait 1.3 seconds. And other case is that this is not true, so I'm still in M3, so I'm rotating in same direction as before last call of spindle control function, and that means that I probably only want to increase RPM or decrease RPM, and I can do that pretty fast. And because of that, I'm in while loop and I only wait 5 milliseconds until my true RPM is less than program RPM. And as I showed in in first 10 of minutes of video, I showed that my true RPM always overshoots program RPM, and because of that, this is how I wrote condition. And if that is not case, so if real RPM is not greater than zero, it means it's less than zero, so it means spindle is in still state and I want to rise RPM from zero to, for example, some X value, 2000, 4000, and I'm in this kind of loop, so I'm waiting until real RPM becomes greater than program RPM, and after it, that is true, I'm leaving this loop, and like I told, after everything that I did in this macro function, I decided to mark this value with value 0. And same is no operator file, open file, same is for M4. So do spindle counterclockwise, so rotate spindle in M4 direction or counterclockwise direction, and I'm checking if real RPM or RPM that I can read from over encoder is greater than zero. That means spindle is rotating. Then check next thing. Was previous state M3? If yes, that means that I'm in situation that I want to reverse direction from M3, now I want M4, and for that I need some amount of time, and as I told for, I don't know, five or six times, I, after testing, concluded that for me that constant is 1.3 seconds, and after that I only need to wait when true RPM will be greater than program RPM, and I will leave this loop in which I check every 5 milliseconds is this condition true. If it's not true, I'm leaving it, and if this is not case, then must be this scenario, and scenario is my spindle was in state of not rotation or zero RPM, and I need to increase it from zero to X RPM, and when I reach or when I overshoot X RPM, I'm leaving this loop, and at the end I'm marking state of RPM direction by leaving this variable to be set with value 1, and I tried my best to explain, I don't know is it good or not, anyway, so I can close this. No, and I can show I can show how much better is how much efficient is machining. There is no unnecessary waiting, so let's leave it like this. In this way it squirts a little bit, so let's leave it like this. Okay, and so Mach 3 cycle, so I need to hold camera cycle. Waited only very short amount of time. Before this I was waiting 10 seconds. And now I need to wait to RPM to change direction. Now I do not need to wait because I'm rotating all the time in M4 direction. Now I need to wait a little bit. So by setting that constant that is currently 1.3 seconds, I can adjust how much do I need wait when I really need to wait something. I waited very little, 5 milliseconds, again, very fast. Very fast, and again, I will show what will happen now. Oops. What will happen when I do this? So oops, need to lock this. So operator, file, open file. So let's assume that this constant is too small. So I will select two seconds. File save, file open. No, I need to put to be bigger so I can show when it really needs to wait something, so 10 seconds or 5 seconds. File, save file, open file, file, 5 seconds, file, save. Okay. So let's see now with 5 seconds. Okay. Psycho. I'm waiting for 4000 RPM. Okay, that is okay. Waited 5 milliseconds. And now I will wait 5 seconds. So 5 seconds. Okay. After this I will not wait because there is no need. There is no need. There is no need because this drill and center drill, they need same direction of spindle to work. And I will wait 5 seconds because I'm changing direction. Okay. Waited 5 milliseconds. With first version of macros I would wait 5 seconds between those two moves. And so conclusion is that 1.3 seconds is little bit too small time. Maybe I will use 1.5 seconds and 5 seconds is too much time. And that time is only used when I have change of direction of rotation. And this is update about Spindle Speed.